Good morning all of you, and today it's a Friday, last day of the week, and today I have decided to show you how to develop a strategy using trend line. ST trend line indicator is there in JForex and the Visual JForex, and with that I will use the parabolic SAR, because last Thursday there was some technical issues, and because of that I failed to show you the test run over the indicator parabolic SAR. So today I will use the same indicator, so that way you will be familiar with the use of parabolic SAR, and the new indicator I will add into that, that is the ST trend line. So first I will make you familiar with the logic on VJForex. Let's go back to the visual JForex, and here you will find it in the add indicators. ST trend line exactly I need. You can simply type trend line and you will get it, okay? So this is the ST trend line Hilbert transform. It is in overlap studies section. Simply add it, okay? Now the logic will be, let me add parabolic SAR. My desired level of entry point will be this. I will highlight the area. You can add the stochastic that way, but today I will not add the stochastic. I will just go with the two indicators. And I will note down the logic so it will be clear to you. So for the buy trade, I want my strategy should open a trade here. So how I will define that? That's exactly I will show you. Buy trade. First thing, price close means candle close should be above. The ST trend line. Now I can add the one more thing, that is a candle low should be below. Like this scenario, okay? See, candle low was below the ST trend line, candle close is above the ST trend line. And then price should have closed above the SAR. So this is the 6 GMT candle and price is 1.120. Let us see the candle closing value. This is a 6 GMT candle and the candle close. Here we will get candle close 1 point open low, no, this one. So 1 point here, this one. SAR 1.120 time. Let me check the time. Low is 2034 and close is 1.12125. And dot value showing 1.12018. So what I will do, I will diff whenever the dot gets formed below the price level and candle closes above the ST trend line with low below the ST trend line and close above the ST trend line, that time strategy should open a buy trade. So this will be the condition for the buy trade. So here in this candle strategy should open a buy trade. Now with that you can define an entry point, but sometimes we may miss a trade, like what happened here. In the second candle, price almost reached to those levels, but it failed to touch the trend line price level, and after that it closed above the previous candle's close. So we may have missed trade in this scenario. That's why I will keep the logic simple. Candle low should be, so it should open the trade exactly in this kind of scenario. So this will be logic for buy trade. And now let us check out the logic for sell trade. These conditions, okay, this kind of scenario I want for the sell trade. Here you can notice candle high above the trend line, candle close below the trend line, SAR is above the price value. That time strategy should open a sell trade. Now we will come to know how it works in automated trading. For the visual manual trading, you can easily decide here, but sometimes psychology helps, psychology creates problem. That's why I want to fit it into automated trading, and we will keep on modifying. We can add the order validity time, how much time it will be valid, if you are going for a pending open block. If not, then simply just I will try with first open at market block, and if it don't give the desired result, I will keep on modifying it. So let's begin. Hope you have got the logic. This is for the buy trade. Let me note down for the sell trade. Third condition I haven't added. Okay, the SAR value should be below candle, or you can give the last tick also. You can define here the last tick value also, below candle close. Or we have got the another option, that is last tick value should be above SAR value. Either you can put this or this one. Sell trade, candle high above the trend line, candle close should be below trend line, this is a good indicator which generates signals as early as it can, but sometimes major deviation will be there, like here. Okay, candle low dot, and then here. So in this kind of scenario, what we can do, we can use an entry price by using the pending open. So that time we can define strategy should open a trade if only it finds last tick price over the trend line price. So I think it will be better to add that condition as well by using the pending open block. Candle close should be below ST trend line. Then third one will be SAR. Candle close should be below SAR. And fourth one will be, we will go for a last tick. Both the options I will decide one. Okay, but first initially we will try with the candle close. And then I will use the pending open block. Okay, let us see how it goes. Last tick value should be below SAR value. So So this will be the conditions for the buy and sell trade. Now let's go back to the Visual Shape Forex. Let's get started. As usual, I will need a 3 e-blocks. Let me check out if everything is right. So in the first, I will define the position amount pending open. So select the option pending positions position amount. That should be less than 1. So it will submit 1 order at a time. And on Monday, I will add the order validity time as well. Time is little less now. Time constraints are there for today. So I will go for order validity time on Monday. Here it will be less than 1. Then define the candle period. The chart pattern I have shown you is of 1 hour. So this is the EURUSD and 1 hour. Okay, so I will define the candle period as 1 hour. Then I will define the candle instrument. That is the Euro USD. Then I need two indicators, ST trend line and SAR. So click on the indicator section. Here click on the other, and here you will find the ST trend line. And in the similar section, you will get the SAR as well. Here it is. Default instrument Euro USD. Simply I will change it to same, because it should be visible at first sight. That is my purpose every day. Then where is Euro USD? Here it is. Then change the time period to 1 hour. SARs, repeat the same procedure, change the instrument and the time period. No need to change the shift values, because we will be dealing with current values only. So rest of the things keep as it is, and simply I will change the name to SAR. Start value 0 and then save. Here trend line, start value 0 and save. Now we will move on to develop a logic. For that need a multiple action to divide the flow in multiple streams. Click on the logical and here you will get it. And then if we will need a 3 blocks each side. So first let us start with the rabbi side. If time permits, I will add the order validity time as well. Then see, first logic is candle close should be above ST trend line, so we need a ST trend line users variable. You will find in them here, and then candle. Okay, we will define the candle low first, should be lower than, so first input less than second input, that means candle low is below the ST trend line. Then candle close should be above ST trend line. And third one, candle last tick price, we have got two options, or candle open, candle high, candle close should be above the SAR. And then I will add the pending open. Sorry. Here I will define the price, entry price should be trend line price. Buy limit, or buy stop, because we want to buy it lower than the current market price, so it's a buy limit and then ST trend line. Now similar thing I will add it to first. We will go for the these three things, and then if it doesn't work as per the requirement, then we have got so many options. I will modify it. Candle close, first in the first block I have described candle low, so here candle high should be last bit candle high, and then I want trend line. It should be above ST trend line. So here in the second A block, define the candle close. Friends, you can develop strategy while watching video only. So side by side, that way it will be easy for you to repeat the procedure and everything will be clear to you. And at the same time, if you face any question, you can type in the comment box. I will answer that in my next video. Candle close should be below trend line. And in the third block, define first input less than second candle close less than ST trend line. And then candle close should be less than SAR. And then I will need pending open. Okay, so I will drag and drop it and increase the space for workspace. So candle close should be less than, and the entry price will be ST trend line, and it will be sell limit. Rest of the things I will keep similar. 3 change the trade amount because this is the micro lot 0.1 instrument euro USD. Still I will change it. Here as well. Trade amount, change it to 0.1. Slippage. Done. Now we have done with the logic. I will save it. LT trend line. I will save it with the name of indicator. Okay, save. LT trend line SAR. And this is the logic. Last candle low for the buy side should be less than trend line, candle close should be above the trend line, and with that last bit candle, candle close should be above the SAR, and then it will open a buy SAR trade over the price of HT trend line here as well. Now let me add the order validity time as well. Calculation, so here we will need elastic tick time, elastic tick time, and then add the, suppose I want it order should be open for 2 hours, so then I will need to add the 72 lakhs millisecond, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, and then here order valid time, start value 0, same. So good till time. Simply sometimes it doesn't work. Let me try it. What I will do, I will take the time from here. I have got the other option this way. Tick time. And then I will add the same thing here. Should be some here. Sorry friends, I forgot to change the setting. Here it seems to me I haven't changed this to price, so it should be price here, and then LT trend line. Stop loss we can calculate, but let it be. I will keep it on pips only today, and I will define the price values on Monday. Just I am little short on time and order validity. Just it creates the problem. Last tick tick time, and then start value, I will simply name it here only, order validity, and that way we have got the second option. So and that variable I will put it here. So last time also I think I have shown you this way. Now it's working. This option also works, but just sometimes it creates problems. So no worries. We have got the another ways. Now I will save it, okay? And then trend line simply. And then export it. Java. Now I feel viewers are exporting, performing a test run. So it's just more than 1.5 months since I started the course. Desktop. Then save it. Now I will go back to the JForex. Desktop is the location where I saved the file. Then open. Compile it. One more time. Wait to compilation successful. Now we can start the test run. Visual mode and then previous month and has begun. Let us wait till it opens. sponsor trade. Yes, it placed the order here. Let me add the indicator. It is working as per our requirement. So trend line. Add. Yes, that time, and then SAR. I say R. Here it seems here it has opened a trade, maybe a buy trade. Okay, so candle low, no, because SAR is here, so I feel it may be a sale trade here, and then it got stopped out here. So here it placed a buy trades. Overall result we will come to know as strategy finishes test run. So we will need to wait for some more time. Let us see. Here, yes, it has placed a buy trade and stopped out, closed position 3. So it is opening a multiple position. We have got solution for that as well, but it is working as per the requirement. So that's why I wanted. Rest of the things we can modify and correct. Now it opened a trade here, and this malfunctioning happens. That's why I always advise viewers to first try the strategy in demo, keep it running in the demo for almost a month, more than a month, then only you should move any strategy to the live. I will not advise viewers or strategy developers should use the strategy in the here. I believe we have got the closed position too. Closed in profit. Now it has start placing multiple orders. So it creates a problem with the pending open block. So we will need to add one more condition there. It should be open position 1 only. Some days before I have shown you it has opened 30 positions. Out of that, and the positions, some of them have closed in profit, but you can notice here it has opened 2775, 222, 316, 315, with little difference 3174, 315, 1.126. I have got a solution for that. And what I will do, I will add open position 1 only. Okay. If so, I will place this block after the order block. Open position, position amount, and we will keep on modifying the strategy. Cancel. G1 or 0, we can put it here, 0, 1, less than, and let us see whether order validity time is working properly or not. Cancelled because of timeout. So order valid is working properly. Cancelled because of timeout. So order is valid only for 2 hours. Okay. Now you can modify that as per the requirement. Okay, now save it. Let me remove that link, otherwise it will create problem. So save the draft, trend line 1, and then save it. Yes, here micro lot is there, and here I will need to change the lot. Let me check the, yes, here it is proper. Now we can add close and cancel. Save draft. Then export it. Java. Okay. Save. And then let us go back to the J4X. Here I will import it. Line 1, open, and follow the same procedure, repeat all the steps, compile it, and then test run it. Compiling, successful. Now start the test run. Visual mode, previous month. And then start. ST trend line. Trend line. Hopefully it is opening one position, placing one order at a time. Now we need a SAR. Okay. SAR. Exactly, it has placed the order here, but I believe that is the sale order, because candle close is above the here, and then here as well. So where I think those trades have closed in loss. So what looks prominent on the candlestick chart may not work that way in the visual automatic trading. So that is another drawback, but we can overcome that by adding certain filters. We have got so many options. And yes, but it is working as per the requirement. See, it has closed the, it has opened a sale and it is closed in profit. Okay, USD 502 profit loss, so it closed in profit. So it is working exactly in the similar manner the way I have designed it. Now we can solve rest of the problems by adding some filters. Here also it opened a sale trade and closed in profit. Now here it opened a sale trade. Let us see what happens, whether we get a stop out or take profit gets filled. Here it opened a sale and it has got stopped out. So 50,000 was the initial deposit, 49,000, EA 300, final deposit. Strategy is in loss, but the logic working the way we want it. Okay, so That is the purpose, to show you how to create a logic, how to. Now we have got the options. We can cancel some trades, like here it has opened, where it is, okay, so here it has opened a sell trade when already there was a move of almost 1.133, means more than 120 pips move was already occurred in the Euro USD. So here, if RSI, we can add the RSI. If RSI is in oversold territory, strategy should avoid a sell trade. When RSI is in overbought territory, strategy should avoid a buy trade. Now we can add that. I will do that on Monday. I will just show you how it will work by adding the RSI. There it is. You will find it in momentum. Now here we can skip the trade by adding the RSI. So when actually RSI is above 50, that time only strategy should open a sell trade or buy trade. So RSI should be in the middle of the strength. It should not be nearing to the oversold or nearing to the overbought. And that way we can avoid certain trades and we can increase the profitability. So that's it for the day, friends. Hope you have enjoyed my lesson. I wish all my friends a very happy weekend and see you on Monday. Thank you for watching and subscribe to our channel, Dukascopy Webinars.